You can't run with a purse over your shoulder, so these women did what many do and hid theirs in their cars.
My purse is always hidden, so it's never out in the open where it can be seen.
You know, I just put it underneath the seat and I would lock my doors.
Both women were inside a building at Memorial Park, getting ready to head back outside for a run with the group called Fleet Feet. But then another group member noticed that two cars had their windows smashed in.
So I went out there and I found one of my windows broken and my purse stolen.
Wallets, phones, checkbooks, identifications, all stolen.
I have an app on my phone for the credit card, and as I was talking to the police, I was getting alerts that they were spending money. Dollar General, Walgreens, they were hitting. The first one was $504 on the card.
While Tanya and Lori had their windows smashed, Appleton police tell me that they're seeing many instances of people having their belongings stolen from their cars that were already unlocked.
Just take a look at this. This theft happened just last month in Appleton with an unlocked car. Tanya and Lori now feel that they were being watched by whoever saw them walk away from their cars without their purses.
You know, I feel like maybe the person was lying in wait somewhere out here watching. I couldn't believe it because there was so much lighting around, you know, so many people around. It happened. I was only in the building maybe 15 minutes.
After being victims of theft, their routines are changing.
5 minutes to get a couple cards off of me has, you know, took a whole day the next day to clear up the mess. But nothing of value will be kept in the car from this point forward.